If you're a business owner, the first thing you should understand is that the success of your business is largely dependent on the success of your employees. The more empowered your employees are, the more they can thrive, grow, and work productively. Rather than doing everything yourself, the managers you have in place should be empowered to enable a work environment that is productive and happy. Your managers should have the permission to take action and make critical decisions. Within your organization, you should have trust in your managers to create the ideal workspace for all your employees.
You don't have to be great to start, but you have to start to be great.
Empowering your managers and employees is crucial for growing a sustainable and profitable business. Though you might have been in charge of growing your company and managing employees at the start of your company, real growth and success is a product of several people working together to achieve the organizational goals. Delegating to your managers instead of a strict business owner employee will multiply the capabilities and strength of your organization. On today's episode, I'll take you through proven and all-encompassing methods of empowering your managers to help your employees and provide a great workspace. But before I give you these proven methods, I want you to drop a comment below sharing your personal experience as a business owner and how you've handled delegating tasks to managers and employees. This episode will take you through the essentials of the ways to empower managers to help your employees to be more productive. Let's discuss each of these methods one after the other. You have to learn how to delegate the task of handling your employees to your managers. Delegate with the intent of growing and developing the responsibilities and capabilities of your managers. This will have the ripple effect of strengthening and empowering all your team members. Set boundaries within which your managers are free to act. Yes, boundaries do not restrict your managers. Instead, they empower them. When you set boundaries, you should let your managers the permission to make decisions that are in alignment with the company goals. This gives them the freedom to act knowing that they are doing the right thing. Some business owners complain that despite the empowerment practices they've tried implementing for the managers in their organization, they still have them coming back with employee problems to solve. Well, one of the ways to resolve this is to offer resources and tools to your managers. Try as much as possible to include your managers in your goal setting and decision-making process. Also, be receptive to hearing your input and ideas. This will empower your managers and it will also help your organization to progress with new ideas. You have to be listening entrepreneurs, one that actually let your managers say the truth rather than tell you what you want to hear. Your managers will be more equipped to help your employees when they know that you believe in them to produce an outstanding performance. Learn how to praise efforts and accomplishments of your managers. This will help them to learn and handle your employees better. Here we go. I just shown you the best ways to empower your managers to help your employees in the best capacity. As you begin implementing them, you'll surely see changes and you'll have more time to focus on company growth. Take care, everybody, and I'll see you in the next video.